Okay, so we analyze the earth. We said that in the middle is a donkey. It's Avram, that equal Chamor. Avram equal Chamor, donkey. The way it is written about Yisachar, Chamor, Garen, with no Vav. White horse, Yitzhak, equal Sus Lavan, the white horse. Now, this writing of the name horse represent the donkey riding on the horse. This is the donkey that riding on the horse. It means when we write the word horse, it is written in the Megillat of Esther, Ve'ir Kivuhu al Asus. They put him on top of the horse. Ve'ir Kivuhu equal Chamor. Right, so all the secret of the white donkey, Chamor Lavan, equal Purim. Purim is the secret of the one white donkey of Mashiach. So they put Mordechai, Mordechai represents the donkey, they put him on top of the horse.
This is what we see on the cover of your book.
Exactly, this is a picture on the cover of my book. And only if you just analyze the word horse, the Vav always have to do the, in the more basic way, the Vav represent the donkey, number six. Okay? Yisachar, if we try to do the same thing with Yisachar, Sus plus Yisachar plus Sus, equal 1082. What is this number? This number is a Nachash, snake, in high symmetry and low symmetry together. I can write Nachash like this. How much equal Nachash like this? Again, Nachash with high symmetry equals 666, what is going together with a snake, of course. Right? The number of the devil. And Nachash...
Chet is... What is Chet?
Eight.
Eight, okay.
Eight.
And Nun is 50.
And when I write Nachash with the low symmetry, I write the more basic number in all my books, that is Yitzchak Yitzchak, what is Mashiach Hen. Yitzchak is a middle point between Mashiach and Hen, that together is three times Yitzchak. Together it's the curse we talk about. So it's of course a snake, it's a curse. Alright, so we make honey from the curse, like it's all our principle. Right, so thank you to... So we have here 1082. When I decide, I was thinking about the name to give to my book. I call it finally, in my first writing, I call it Tzipor Medaberet.
First draft.
Yes, I call it Tzipor Medaberet Chen, with the acronym of Tzemach. The plant. Semar Shmo equal Ariel Ariel. So I decide to call it Tzipor Medaberet Chen. But I have a thought, a bird talk Chen. It's more natural to say a bird talk with Chen, with grace, Bechen. So then Tzipor Medaberet Bechen equal this number, the perfection of the snake. Bechen, it is written about Mashiach. The Mashiach called Even Bochan, a stone of examination, of Bochan. Okay. From the prophecy of Yeshayahu. So it is a I have a thought to call it, finally I decided to call it Tzipor Medaberet Chen. Okay, there are, of course, good reason for here and for here. Alright, so this was about the symmetry that we have. Like we said, we have two Aleph. If I just talk about the family of David, this is Shlomo, this is David, this is Yishai, this is David. And this is Shlomo. Jesus is not son of David. He is David himself. Like he said by himself. He has a Mashiach, son of who he is. And they tell him, well, he's a son of David. So then he asks, Hakam. Okay, so it's why David Ben Yishai, David, son of Yishai, equaling him at Yeshua. So, if I do the gematria of this symmetry, let's see what we are going to receive with Shlomo plus David plus Yishai plus David plus Shlomo. How much equal together? Three times the Book of God, Sefer Hashem. Three times. It means nine times cross. Alright, so this example of a thing that really working when we do it in symmetry. We can parallel this concept talking about the Chaya, what is represented by the name Yeshua in the isometry. So we can parallel each one of these concepts to each one of the letters of Yeshua. The Ein is a snake and is a Tik Yomin as well, this is the letter Ein. The letter Ein. The Vav, the Son, always the Vav represents the Son, is David, here in the middle. It's Jesus here and the Rabbi here. Instead of Yishai, we have Shaish, exactly the same letter opposite. Like we said, what is Yishai? Is Yareach plus Shemesh plus Yareach. Is a moon plus sun plus moon. Yishai. And here we have Shemesh plus Yareach plus Shemesh. So, Shaish,
marble.
Marble. When you get to a place of pure marble, don't say water, water. Don't say water, water.
Where is this from?
Is a said of in the Talmud when there was in the to the Pardes when they did the Aliyat Neshama to the Pardes. They say when you get to a place of pure marble, Shai Shtaor, don't say water, water. It means don't separate the low water from the high water, or in all these concepts, the low water from the high water. Okay, so in this place, in the middle, between the, in the middle here, this is a shayish, and it's yishai as well. It's completely opposite letter, like you can see. If I talk about Menachem Mendel as a son, Shemesh is Shin Mem Shin, but the acronym of Menachem Mendel Shmorson is Tumem and Shin, like we said. So it's a game with the symmetry. It means in the point of wisdom, you must to be able to see two different symmetry. Because if I talk only about these two concepts, Yitzhak inside and Avram is outside. But if I talk about these two concepts, Avram is inside and Yitzhak is outside.
Inside, outside what?
It is the appearance, it is the inside the soul. Oh. Like, if I talk about Shemesh, this is Yitzhak, this is Avram, this is Yitzhak. Okay? But only if I talk only about Arabi, this concept. The Rabbi above the Chochmah is this concept, is Yitzhak and Avram. It's not again Yitzhak. And if I talk about the Rabbi, the way he appear here is inside Avram and outside Yitzhak. It's when I get this letter. When I talk about Yaakov concept, the son, the way Yaakov, the way Jesus is like Yaakov, the way Yaakov has a son, when Yaakov is a son, this will be a son like this, like Menachem Mendel. See, it means it will be two men, it will be Avram outside and it will be Yitzhak inside. When I talk about the son, the way Esav see it, it will be a son with Esav in the middle and Yaakov outside. All right, so it is a main concept that the Torah tell us the way it's supposed to be. What is Dak Mechuspas Dak, Avram inside and Yitzhak outside, like the word Shemesh. But still we have the two possibility here in this game between these two things. We are both together. It's difficult to understand this, but if this is here, it's one thing. It's all one thing. But it's one thing that all the two opposite. That from one point of view, you have Avram inside and Yitzhak outside. From another point of view, you have Yitzhak inside and Avram outside. Okay? If we talk about the faces, Partsuf equal Tehna too. You know the faces in Kabbalah. Partsuf equal Tehna, Avram plus Yitzhak. The Partsuf here, Yitzhak is outside and Avram is inside. The Partsuf here, again, Avram is Avram is like Yaakov. Avram is inside and Yitzchak is outside. In this parsuf, Yitzchak is inside, Yitzchak is like Esav, and Yishmael is like Avram, is outside. Okay? And in this verse too, Yitzchak is inside and Avram is outside. Okay? But when we talk about connection between these three points, we have the two opposite things happen both together. And this is all the secret of the wisdom of the point of the middle of symmetry that really contain all the opposite. And it was from this point everything become new. We talk here about the mother of Mashiach, the Virgin. It means she become new all the time. Why she become new all the time? Because she has this point of understanding inside of in her middle. Right? She has the Yud in the middle. And the Yud is nothing. Achokhmah me'aintimase, the wisdom came from nothing. It came from nothing, it means it can come always in completely opposite way. It can appear in any way you way. Any way you want, it can appear. The power in the soul of putting letters together and changing permutation is the power of the Chochmah. Matzref la Chochmah. Letzref otiyot, to make different permutation of letter is the power of the wisdom. The wisdom, it gives us the power to speak. To speak to find always different combination of letter. The power of speech came from the wisdom, from the Chaya.
The Chochmah.
Yeah. And it's a correction of Chava. It's me. Chava, it's like it's a female. And the Chaya, it means she has the Yud inside of her. The Vav, what is a snake, it's like a vector of energy. I go from here to here. Really? No, I just, nothing didn't change, never. We are just focused to the middle point because it's all symmetry. Nothing don't change. Ani avaya lo shaniti.
It's the Yud.
The Yud. In the moment I am connected to this point of symmetry, this is a place where the eternal life came from. Yamutu velo b'chokhma. They die because they don't have wisdom.
Is the Yud or the Kutso shel Yud?
Yud.
The point.
No. The Yud. The Kutso shel Yud is a crown.
Because Yud is not a point. You call it a point.
Yud is a point. The Chokhma is a point. Is the concept of the point.
Okay?
In the Yud, you have a hint for the Yesod Abba to something that you take from the point to the female, what is a seed, etc. So is the Yud that going down like this. And it is a hint for what is above the Yud, what is the crown, that is it point on top to the crown, to the Mashiach that is above. But to achieve the Mashiach that is above, you must have this in the middle. And if you understand the symmetry here, this becomes this, and after in the resurrection of the dead, this becomes this. The body will become God Himself. And this, Yitzchak here becomes Yitzchak here.
So the two
and
are,
then you don't the know two... anymore if this is a Shemesh like this or a Shemesh like this.
Hold on. So there are two Alephs. So one is like this world and the other one is the upper world? Or
yes. Yeah, you can understand.
Like duality and
You can understand
world.
This like the reality outside of myself and inside of myself. You can understand this like reality before the construction of the creation and after the construction. You can understand this in different level of oneness. Basically, here we talk about Olam Atzilut, or all the four word even, Olam Atzilut. Here we talk really about a relationship between a rabbi and a disciple. So we talk about the Chabad. There's a three high spheres of Olam Atzilut. Okay? This is Abba Ila'a, this is Ima Ila'a, this is Yisrael Saba, this is Tvuna. The four partsufim, the four faces of the Chabad, of the brain, in Olam Atzilut. Here we talk about the crown of Olam Atzilut. Okay, so this is Atik Yomi, this is Arich Anpi, this is the Chaya that is a little bit above the wisdom. It is a question. There are places that you will find in Kabbalah that the Chaya is belong to Arich, is belong to the crown. And it is placed, it is written that the Chaya is the wisdom. Alright, so you can see why the Chaya have to do with something that it's above the wisdom too. And here it's a little below the wisdom too. So all this has to do with the Chaya. Even we talk here basically about the Neshama.